Hello friends, this video on Coordination Compound Part 11 is brought to you by examfear.com. No more fear from exam. Now as we have seen so many coordination compound, we have seen the names of the coordination compound and we know little bit about the structure also, not much. But now we'll see the isomerism in the coordination compound. See, what is isomer? Isomers are nothing but two or more compound that have same chemical formula but different arrangement in the space. And because of this different arrangement in the space, they have different physical and chemical properties. Okay, so we have stereoisomerism. Stereoisomerism, if you see, they have same formula and the bond, correct? They have same formula and the bond. For example, if you see both of these are the same formula and the bond is also same. If you see COCl is one bond, here also COCl is one bond. COCl is one bond, COCl is one bond. CoN is one bond, NS3, CoN is one bond. CoN is one bond, 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 CoN is one bond. So you see, the formula is same, the bond is also same. But the difference is the spatial arrangement. They are cis and trans. If you see, in this case, two proline molecules are together, they are called cis, two proline molecules apart from each other, trans. Just they have different spatial arrangement, but they have same bond. The next kind of isomerism is called, and in this we have geometrical isomerism, optical isomerism, we will study that. The next kind of isomerism is called structural isomerism. In this, they have different bond. If you see here, cobalt has a bond with nitrogen here, cobalt has a bond with oxygen here. But the chemical formula is same in both cases. If you count the number of nitrogen, oxygen, hydrogen, cobalt, in both cases it will be same. You see, cobalt is 1, nitrogen is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Here also 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Nitrogen is same. Oxygen is 1, 2. Oxygen is 1, 2. Hydrogen is 1, 3, 6, 9, 12, 15. Here also 3, 6, 9, 12, 15. So both have same chemical formula. Number of atoms is the same, but the bond is different. You see, we have different bond. So they are called structural isomerism. So we have stereoisomerism and structural isomerism. In stereoisomerism, the bond is also same, but the only difference is the arrangement, the way same bond and light different arrangement also. Okay, and in this case, structural isomerism, we have different bond altogether. Okay, so in kind of structural isomerism, we'll study linkage isomerism, we'll study coordination isomerism, we'll study ionization isomerism, solvate isomerism, we'll study all the isomerism. Let's start with stereoisomerism. So as I told, stereoisomerism, we have same molecular formula, but different arrangement. They have same bond also. So the formula is same and the bond is same. Let me write once again. Same bond, different arrangement. Example, you see, the bonds are all same. We just told 2 COCl bond, 2 COCl bond, 4 CO and N bond, they all bonded to N, 4 CO N bond, here also 4 CO N bond. Bond is same, the chemical formula is same, but the arrangement is different. The 3D arrangement is different in space. So we have in this, we have geometrical isomerism and optical isomerism. So let's study geometrical isomerism now. So this type of isomerism arises in heteroleptic complex. So if you see, heteroleptic complex, we have told, is where we have different types of ligands. For example, in this case, the ligand is NH3 and Cl. So in homoleptic ligand, it will be all same. So the example, if I have PT and I have Cl, Cl, all Cl, okay, it doesn't matter. The orientation won't matter because every time you will get, if you replace this Cl with this Cl, you will get the same complex. So in homoleptic complex, this is not possible. Only happens in the case of heteroleptic. Okay, heteroleptic complex. This is possible. Okay. So if we talk about unidentate ligands, so we have different format. For example, you have this kind of MX2 and L2, where X2 and L2 are two different ligands. For example, in this case, MSP platinum, X is, let's suppose, ammonia, and L is chlorine. So in this kind of structure, you get cis and trans. So if you see, this is cis, both chlorine on the same side, trans, both chlorine on the different side. Okay, or you can also get something like M, A, B, C, D, where all these A, B, C, D are four different ligands. There also you can get. Okay, and please note, this is not possible for tetrahedral complex, because tetrahedral complex, if you see it this way, you start from this point, all these points are symmetrical. Okay, same distance, same angle, everything is same. So tetrahedral complex, typically you won't find geometrical isomerism for unidentate ligands. Octahedral you will find, for example, same thing, MX2L4 kind of thing. We have four ligands of type 1 and two ligands of type 1. Example, in this case, we see two chlorines and four ammonia. So here also you see cis and trans. Okay, so geometrical isomerism is typically by the orientation in the space. In the case of didentate ligand also, you will see, for example, in this case, I have a metal and I have two ligands, this unidentate, and two ligands didentate. Here also you will see cis and trans, cis and cis trans. Right? So for tetrahedral, typically you won't find. Octahedral, square planar, you will find geometrical isomerism. Okay, so we have studied a lot about geometrical isomerism in the previous chapters. I believe if you want, we can see that videos and understand this concept more deeply. We'll take one numerical on this geometrical isomerism. So what is the why is geometrical isomerism not possible in tetrahedral complex? I just explained it's not possible. It is not possible in a tetrahedral complex with two different unidentate ligands. That means it is telling that something of this form. Two different unidentate ligands, MX2L2 form or MX L3 form or MX3L form. It means there are two different unidentate ligands, and it can be in this proportion, either 2, 2, 1, 3 or 3, 1. So in all these cases, isomerism is not possible, because if you see the tetrahedral geometry, you start from here to any point, it's all same. Right? The relative position of ligands attached to the central atoms are same with respect to each other. So there is no point, there is no possibility of geometrical isomerism. Okay, example, here you have, let's suppose, 2x and 2l. Now you put 2x, 2l here, or you put 1x, 1x, 1l, 1la. Actually, they are two same. These two are same, actually, because from with respect to m, all these are in the same position. So it doesn't matter. It's all same. So geometrical isomerism is not possible. Optical is possible. Geometrical is not possible. Okay, so let's talk about the optical isomerism. Let's talk about the concept first. You see, and we have seen this slide actually, this term chiral is actually used to describe objects that are not superimposable on its mirror image. You take an object and you take a mirror image. You try to superimpose, it will not be superimposable. You take your hand, you take a reflection of your hand, and then you try to take a mirror image. Image of your hand and try to superimpose, it won't happen. For example, this is the hand, this is the mirror image of this, then you won't be able to superimpose on this. Similarly, if you see this is a compound, this is an organic compound actually, and you take a mirror image, and these two are non-superimposable. Right here, if you see, they are non-superimposable. And that's the concept of optical isomerism, and they actually show different behavior when you pass this light. They have this optical activity actually. When you pass this beam of light, and this light, the beam of polarized light actually, when you pass this beam of polarized light, this polarized light is rotated either left or right, depending on compound. For example, this compound, they both look same. Both are tetrahedral, and if you talk about the geometrical isomerism, they are same. There is no difference. But actually, they have different optical activity. One, rotates the light on the right clockwise, and one on the anti-clockwise direction, correct? And that's we have this optical eye. So we have dextrorotatory, which rotates the polarized light towards right, and for example, this one is rotated towards right. This is dextro, and we have levo L for left. So this rotates the lights towards left. See, the light was this, it is now left. So there are two forms of color. This is the basic concept of optical isomerism. Okay, and these are called enantiomers. They can't be superimposed. Okay, so let's see this optical isomerism in this term. And this is common actually in the octahedral complex. Octahedral complex, and that too which involves didendered ligands. For example, in this case, both are cis. This is trans. In trans, we don't have optical isomerism. In cis, if you see, this is one ligand. This is one ligand. Both are in the same side. Okay. So, and this is also one ligand. This is one ligand. In fact, these two are mirror image. This is dextro and this is levo. But in case of trans, if you find the mirror image, it will exactly superimpose on this. So you won't find optical isomerism here. Okay. In case of cis, yes, optical isomerism is possible. In case of trans, optical isomerism is not there. In this case, because if you take a mirror image of this, you'll get exactly the same thing. This is what I'm saying. Some metal, some metal, some metal, some metal. You take a mirror image. Take a mirror image of this, you'll get exactly the same thing. Right? And this will be superimposable. You can actually put this on this. So they are not optically active, but this cyst is optically active here. Okay, so a coordination compound which can rotate the plane of polarized light in some direction is called optically active. Okay, so I have cis and trans of this. This is nothing but COCl2 into plus ion. So in this, if you see, the cis will exhibit optical activity, but the trans will not exhibit any optical activity. Okay. More, if you see here, COEn32. Here also, if you see, if you take this mirror image. This is what exactly the mirror image is. This is dextro and this is levo. They are not superimposable. They are non-superimposable, and this is devo and this is levo rotatory. So this particular compound also exhibit optical isomers. Okay. Let's take some numerical to understand this more. So let's draw the structural geometrical isomers for this particular compound. So if you see FeNH3 and CN4, so there are two NH3 molecules and four CN4. So if you put one NH3 here. Let's suppose this is my central atom iron and one NH3 here. This is octahedral, pretty easy you can make out because there are 4 plus 2, 6 ligands, 6 coordination number is typically octahedral. And then you can put 4 CN here. That is one possibility. Okay. And in this case, if you see, this is trans, because these two NH3 molecules are separated by 180 degree. The other possibility is you have this iron and it may draw the same structure. Right? So we have one NH3 here, and the other NH3 you can put here. And the remaining four you can put CN. Actually, you put NC here, right? Because it is bonded to nitrogen, not carbon. Okay, anyway, that doesn't make much difference. So now if you see, this is cis, two nitrogen molecules together, and this is trans, two nitrogen molecules separated by 180 degree, and these are the only two isomers you can make, geometrical isomers you can make for this particular above. Why not more this triangle? See, here, this, since this is octahedral, you see from here or here, it's all same. I mean, you can be from any direction, you can actually flip this. Okay, so the only thing you have to see here is the angle. So if one case where all the ammonias are in 90 degree angle, other case where these ammonias are in 180 degree angle. These are the two possible combinations here. Right. Remaining place anyway you can fill with CN. Okay. So for example, you want to draw third isomers. If ammonia is here, you can have only two possibilities, one ammonia here or one ammonia here. Because ammonia here, 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 here is all same, it doesn't make much difference. For example, in this case, even if you try to make this kind of isomer and you say it's a different, but actually that won't be different. When I'm talking about geometrical isomers now, right? I'm not talking about the optical activity, I'm talking only about the geometrical. You see, this and these are same. Why? Because nitrogen is 90 degree with this, sorry, this ammonia is 90 degree with this ammonia, here also same, right? There is no difference actually, but they're same. Correct? If you see from ammonia view, actually, if you see from this view, how it looks, you see one ammonia and four CN. Here also you see one ammonia and four CN. And then you see one CN here. You see one CN. Both are same. But these two are different. From here, if you see four ammonia, four CN here. And then one ammonia. So that's how the difference is. You have to visualize the structures. It needs some critical thinking to understand the structures. Think from the angular perspective. Think from the fact that you can see from this ammonia and how it looks. Rotation is possible. Rotation will not change the geometric license. Because the same thing, if you rotate, that does not create any new compound. Because these compounds actually rotates in the space. They are free to rotate. They are free to rotate, so you can see from any angle. Same thing, this compound actually, both these you can actually get by rotating. If you have this compound, you can actually flip it. One, two, and three rotation if you make, like this, right? This is one rotation, this is two rotation, this is three rotation. You'll actually get this. Okay. So the next is, out of the following coordination entities, which is optically active? So let's see. So if you create a mirror image and the mirror image is not superimposable, then that means it is optically active. The first is cis Cl2 and OX2. OX2 is bidentin, that means 2 plus 2, 4 and plus 2, 6. This is also octahedral. Coordination number is 6. Okay. So let's try to create for this. So this is chromium. I'm creating for one. And I have chlorine here, I have two chlorines, the chlorine, and then we have OX. So let's join these to form OX. And join these two actually form OX. This is one possibility. Okay. This is cis actually, both the chlorine are together. Cis is already given the cis. The other is trans for this. Let's do a trans for this. In trans, we'll have two chlorine molecules separated apart from each other. Okay, then this 2OX actually you can form in this fashion. Or you can form in this fashion also, both are same. You actually rotate this, will be the same balance. This is one possibility. So in this case, if you take a mirror image and you try to superimpose, it will superimpose. See, whatever you get is same exactly. If you take a mirror image, you get exactly same and you can superimpose. But if you take a mirror image of this and try to superimpose, let me draw a mirror image of this. Okay, so this side we have chlorine, this side we have chlorine, that is done. These two we have OX, and these two we have OX. So if you see, these two are not superimposable. Even if you rotate this, you will see that these two are not superimposable. Okay, so these two are not superimposable, that means what? They are optically active. So I can say that, yes, सिस इज ऑप्टिकल रिएक्टर। द ट्रांस इज नॉट ऑप्टिकल रिएक्टर। ओके थैंक यू। विजिट examfia.com टू वॉच मोर वीडियोज, अटेंड फ्री ऑनलाइन टेस्ट, गेट फ्री स्टडी मटेरियल्स, फाइंड ट्यूटर्स एंड मेंटर्स एंड मच मोर। थैंक्स वंस अगेन।